Hello everyone, welcome back to the course Power System Operation and Control. In the earlier videos, we have discussed about asynchronous machine modeling. In this lecture onwards, we will start with the unit number 3, which is modeling of excitation and speed governing system. So let us start with the excitation system used for the synchronous generator. The basic function of an excitation system is to provide direct current to the synchronous machine field winding. In addition, the excitation system performs control and protective functions essential to satisfactory performance of the power system by controlling the field voltage and thereby the field current. The control function includes the control of voltage and reactive power flow, and the enhancement of power system stability as well. The protective functions ensure that the capability of the synchronous machine's limit, excitation system, and other requirements are not exceeded. Let us start with the requirements of the excitation system, which will be divided into two parts. First is the generator considerations, and other is the power system considerations. Let us see the generator considerations. The basic requirement is that the excitation system supply and automatically adjust the field current of the synchronous generator to maintain the terminal voltage as the output varies within the continuous capability of the generator. In addition, excitation system must be respond to transient disturbance with field forcing consistent with the generator instantaneous and short-term capabilities. The generator capabilities in this regard are limited by several factors: rotor insulation failure due to high voltage, that is high field voltage, rotor heating due to high field current, stator heating due to high armature current loading, core and heating during unexcited operation, and the heating due to the excess flux. The thermal limits have time dependent characteristics, and the short term overload capability of the generators may extend from 15 to 60 seconds. To ensure the best utilization of the excitation system, it should be capable of meeting the system's need by taking full advantage of the generator's short-term capabilities without exceeding their limits. Now let's see power system considerations. From the power system point of view, the excitation system should contribute to effective control of voltage and enhancement of power system stability. It should be capable of responding rapidly to the disturbance so as to enhance transient stability, and of the modulating generator field so as to enhance small signal stability of the power system. Historically, the role of excitation system in enhancing power system performance has been growing continuously. Early excitation systems were controlled manually to maintain the desired generator terminal voltage and the reactive power loading. When the voltage control was first automated, it was very slow, basically filling the role of an alert operator. In the early 1920s, the potential of enhancing small signal and transient stability through use of continuous and fast acting regulators was recognized. Greater interest in the design of excitation system developed, and exciters and voltage regulators with the faster response were soon introduced to the industry. Excitation system have since undergone continuous revolutions. In the early 1960s, the role of excitation system was expanded by using auxiliary stabilizing signals in addition to the terminal voltage error signal to control the field voltage to damp system oscillations. This part of excitation control is referred to as the power system stabilizers. Modern excitation systems are capable of providing practically instantaneous response with high selling voltage. The combination of high field forcing capability and the use of auxiliary stabilizing signals contribute to substantial enhancement of overall system dynamic performance. Now let's see the excitation system's requirement which it should must fulfill for the power system requirements. First, it needs to meet the specified response criteria. It must be provide limiting and protective functions as required to prevent damage to itself, the generator, and the other equipments. It should meet specified requirements for operating flexibility, and it should meet the desired reliability and the availability by incorporating the necessary level of redundancy and internal fault detection and the isolation capability. So these are the requirement of the excitation system from generator point of view as well as power system point of view. So in a power generation, the excitation system plays a vital role. Now let's move further for the elements of an excitation system. This is the block diagram which shows a synchronous generator excitation control system in which we have exciter, we have the regulator, then terminal voltage and transducer, load compensator, power system stabilizers, limiters, and protective circuits. So let's see functions and its detailing one by one. First, exciter. It provides DC power to the synchronous machine field winding, constituting the power stage of the excitation system. Second, regulator. It processes and amplifies input control signal to the level and form appropriate for control of the exciter. This includes both regulating and excitation system stabilizing functions, that is rate feedback or lead lag compensation. Then third, the terminal voltage transducer and load compensator. It senses the generator terminal voltage, rectifies and filters it to DC quantity, second, regulator. It processes and amplifies input control signal to a level and form appropriate for control of the exciter. This includes both regulating and excitation system stabilizing functions, which includes rate feedback or lag lead compensation. The third part of the control circuit is terminal voltage transducer and load compensator. It senses generator terminal voltage, rectifies and filters it to DC quantity, and compares it with a reference which represents the desired terminal voltage. In addition, load compensation may be provided if it is desired to hold constant voltage at some point electrically remote from the generator terminal. For example, partway through the step-up transformer. Next part is the power system stabilizer. It provides an additional input signal to the regulator to damp power system oscillations. Some commonly used input signal are rotor speed deviation, accelerating power, and frequency deviation. And the fifth part of the control circuit is the limiters and protective circuit. These includes wide array of control and protective functions which ensures that the capability limits of the exciter and the synchronous generator are not exceeded. Some of the commonly used functions are the field current limiter, maximum excitation limiter, terminal voltage limiter, volts per hertz regulator, and protection and under excitation limiter. These are normally distinct circuit and their output signal may be applied to the excitation system at various location as a summing point or a gated input. So this is the details about the excitation system for the synchronous generator. Let's move towards the classification of the excitation system. So there are three types of excitation system. First is the DC excitation system. Second is the AC excitation system. And third is the static excitation system. Excitation systems have taken many forms over the years of their evolutions. They are classified into specified three categories: DC, AC, and static excitation systems. In this discussion, we will discuss about the details about the DC excitation system. Then after, we will proceed for the AC excitation system and then static excitation system. Let us start with the DC excitation system. The excitation system of this category utilizes DC generators as a source of excitation power and provide current to the rotor of the synchronous machine through slip rings, as shown in the schematic diagram. The exciter may be driven by the motor or the shaft of the generator. It may be either self-excited or separately excited. When separately excited, the exciter field is supplied by a pilot exciter consisting of a permanent magnet generator. DC excitation system represents early systems spanning the years from the 1920s to 1960s. The voltage regulators of such system range all the way from the early non-continuously acting rheostatic type of the larger system utilizing main stages of magnetic amplifiers and rotating amplifiers. DC excitation systems are gradually disappearing as many older systems are being replaced by AC or static types of systems. So earlier DC excitation systems has been used, and then after year by year, as there are developments comes into the picture, it DC excitation systems replaced by either AC excitation systems or static excitation systems. In some cases, the voltage regulators along have been replaced by the modern solid state electronic regulators, as many of the DC excitation systems are still in services. They still require modeling in stability studies. Figure shows the schematic of simplified representation of typical DC excitation system with an amplitude voltage regulator. It consists a DC commutator exciter which supplies direct current to the main generator field through the slip rings. An amplitude is a special type of general class of rotating amplifiers known as meterines. It is a DC machine of special construction having two sets of brushes 90 degrees electrical apart. One set on its direct, that is D axis, and other is on the quadrature, that is Q axis. The control field windings are located on the direct axis. A compensating winding in series with the direct axis load produces flux equal and opposite to the direct axis armature current, thereby canceling negative feedback of the armature reaction. The brushes on the quadrature axis are shorted, and very little control field power is required to produce a large current in the quadrature axis armature. The quadrature axis current produces the principal magnetic field and the power required to sustain the quadrature axis current is supplied mechanically by the motor driving the amplidyne. The result is a device with a power amplification on the order of 10,000 to 1 lakh and a time constant in the range of 0.02 to 0.25 seconds. The excitation system details are as shown in the figure. The amplidyne provides incremental changes to the exciter field in a back boost scheme. The exciter output provides the rest of its own field by self-excitation. If the amplitude regulator is out of service, the exciter field is on manual control and is changed through the adjustment of the field rheostat. So in this DC excitation system, as we have discussed, the amplitude voltage regulator. So when there is a requirement of controlling of excitation system, this whole control loop comes into the picture. So initially the output of the generator has been sensed, and accordingly if there is a error, that error will be get amplified, and accordingly the voltage is given to the DC exciter, that is field winding of the DC exciter. And accordingly, DC exciter's armature will produce proportionate amount of DC voltage, which will be given to the main field of the DC, main field of the generator through the slip rings, by which we can compensate the required amount of error in the excitation. So this is how the DC excitation system works. In the next lecture, we will discuss about the AC excitation system and static excitation system. Thank you.